for a Chicago street fight, and he's in action tonight, Ahmed Johnson.
First, you got Marlena all shook up. Now she's taking shots at the hitman. Just who is this bionic woman?
It's being called a classic. We'll take another look at the European Championship match between the British Bulldog and Owen Hart.
All that and much more tonight on Shotgun Saturday Night. Hello again, everybody, and welcome to Shotgun Saturday Night. Here comes Ahmed Johnson. I'm Jim Ross alongside James E. Cornette and the voice of the WWF here in Germany. Carsten Schaefer has just introduced the man of the hour, powerful Ahmed Johnson, who James E. is on his way to WrestleMania 13.
Oh, come in, Berlin. That's exactly the scene tonight, and that's exactly what's on Ahmed Johnson's mind. He's going to kick some butt here in Germany, and then he's going straight for WrestleMania 13 and that Chicago Street Fight Challenge. But, JR, you heard him at the top of the show. What does he mean when he says he's not coming alone?
Well, a lot of speculation regarding that statement, and I'm sure it'll become more and more clear in the upcoming weeks, but Ahmed Johnson has a huge challenge awaiting him in the no-holds-barred Chicago Street Fight. Remember, anything goes in the Chicago Street Fight. You come dressed as you are, wearing battle attire, if you will.
Could be cowboy boots, could be combat boots, blue jeans, belt buckles. I've seen some guys wear spurs. Anything goes in a street fight match. And right there in Chicago at WrestleMania, it's going to be Ahmed Johnson and Farouk. But the Nation of Domination has got to figure into this.
Again, we are coming to you from Berlin, Germany. Ahmed Johnson set to go one-on-one with Leif Cassidy here. Of course, Ahmed Johnson nursing an injured arm. We'll keep our eye on that. Ahmed leaving the hospital in Lowell, Massachusetts several weeks ago to join us in Nashville on Raw, and certainly surprising the entire Nation of Domination. And all I can say, it's a good thing that the Nation is not here in Germany, or we would be having more problems than we already are.
It'd make World War II look like a church social if the Nation was in Germany here with Ahmed Johnson. But I think Leif Cassidy, who's a smart wrestler, who's a great technical wrestler, but also a cunning wrestler, is going to have to take advantage of that arm that's still not fully healed if he expects to come out on top in this one.
It's Ahmed's left arm that is injured. Of course, Ahmed Johnson has already been hospitalized twice at the hands of Farouk in the Nation of Domination. And what a right that knocks Leif Cassidy down to his knees. Ahmed Johnson, 6'3", 305 pounds, and Cassidy focusing right in on that arm.
I knew he was going to have to do that, and that infection, it was ugly to look at. He's got to stay on that arm.
Nothing but power from the Pearl River powerhouse. Ahmed Johnson just 2 weeks away from WrestleMania, and there's no doubt about it, that Chicago Street Fight does indeed have Slobberknocker written all over it. It will not be pretty when Farouk and no doubt the entire Nation will be hanging around like the gang that they are when Farouk takes on Ahmed. And Cornette, look at this power.
Beautiful strength on the vertical suplex keeps him up. The blood rushing to the head. He's one hand. Did you see that? He had him up there with one arm, JR. And Cassidy may have been almost unconscious before he hit the ground.
Ahmed with the scary power is very popular here in Germany. The scissors kick, very popular internationally as far as that's concerned. Remember, Ahmed Johnson won the first ever Kuwaiti Cup last year. Ahmed Johnson in firm control here would be somewhat of a understatement.
I still got to wonder, what is he talking? Oh, right into the post. What is he talking about when he says he's not going to come alone to WrestleMania in Chicago? I know all the top WWF superstars are already spoken for in their own matches with their own problems.
Watch this. Ahmed Johnson couldn't negotiate the shoulder block. Found nothing but the steel ring post on that injured left arm. And again, Leif Cassidy with an armbar takedown. Very sound maneuver. And the powerhouse, Ahmed Johnson, is in trouble. Leif Cassidy is doing the only thing he can do, and that is to focus on the injured left arm of Ahmed Johnson.
And he's doing it quite successfully, and he's doing it quite viciously, and it may just pay off for it. Because I saw that infection that Ahmed had when he was struck with that two before by Farouk. A piece of the board splintered into his arm. He didn't know it was there, and a couple of days later, he had a baseball-sized growth on the side of his bicep. That thing, it was infected badly, and it's still not fully healed. And you can see that Leif Cassidy is making the most of it.
Ahmed Johnson's arm is bleeding. That open wound has been reopened. And Leif Cassidy is doing all he can to continue to wear down Ahmed Johnson. I'm sure that wherever Farouk and the Nation of Domination are, that they are enjoying what they are seeing here.
And they're taking note. They realize that arm's not 100%, and it's only got just a short time, just a couple of weeks away, before WrestleMania and a street fight where anything is legal.
Ahmed Johnson fighting back as elementary as an athlete can, with nothing but right hands, nothing scientific or technical about this style from Ahmed Johnson. Ahmed knows he is a marked man, and what an upset this would be if Leif Cassidy could come out of nowhere to beat Ahmed Johnson, injured arm or not.
Johnson, his desire was so strong, that burning desire to get back in the ring, to show that Farouk and the Nation didn't put him down, didn't put him out. He had to prove it to everybody, but it may have violated the rules of common sense for him to come back this soon from an injury like that.
It's almost as if Leif Cassidy can sense that he has a distinct advantage here and maybe just moments away from upsetting the former Intercontinental Champion, a man whose date with destiny is Sunday, March 23rd in the Rosemont Horizon in Chicago, Illinois at WrestleMania 13.
That's what pride will do to you. That's what, wait a minute!
Left arm, injured or not, Ahmed Johnson just delivered a thunderous clothesline that caught Leif Cassidy either across the bridge of the nose or right in the mouth. In any event, Cassidy goes down, and now Ahmed Johnson may have the opportunity to put Cassidy away.
Cassidy was on the verge of this thing, but I see it slipping away. He's got to do something. He's got to get back to that arm. He's got to avoid this.
Ahmed Johnson with that
power.
There's an intense competitor, 305 pounds, on his way to Chicago to put his career on the line in a Chicago street fight against Farouk. And there's a spine buster.
The pile driver and the spine buster, that has to be enough. But Ahmed Johnson, he's trying to prove a point to the whole Nation of Domination. You didn't put me down. You didn't put me out. And I'm going to be there in Chicago. I guarantee you. That's what he's saying.
We've seen this move delivered on a car and on a table.
Ooh.
And Leif Cassidy is a beaten man thanks to the powerhouse, the Pearl River powerhouse, using the Pearl River plunge.
Ahmed Johnson, you can take another look at it. First, the big sidewalk slam spinebuster. Then, the Pearl River plunge. Leif Cassidy unable to escape. And Ahmed Johnson has his date with destiny on the 23rd, JR.
WrestleMania 13, what an event is going to be. And folks, 2 weeks ago on Raw, the Legion of Doom returned to the WWF and made a huge impact. WrestleMania 13.
You know, a lot of guys around here, Nation of Domination, talking about how hard they had it in the street. You don't know nothing about the streets. We're like these people out here. We are from the streets. Chicago, home of this year's WrestleMania and Hulk and I. We hope with all our might that we will be at WrestleMania 2. sleeping on your cardboard mattress and you wake up, not because you got an alarm clock. You wake up because a sewer rat is biting your big toe. And that is what the LOD is all about. And mentally...
What about that mental attitude?
The last time we had our psychological profiles checked, it wasn't good. It never has been. And it never will be. Because you know something? We like the way we are. It's everybody else that has to wrestle us that doesn't like the way we are.
Berlin, Germany on Shotgun. Tag team action. Furnace and LaFon take on Bob Holly and Aldo Montoya.
Also, we'll take another look at that classic battle for the European title between the British Bulldog and Owen Hart.
And up next, that's no Fraulein. That's the Bionic Woman, and she wants a shot at the Hitman. Welcome back, everybody, to Shotgun from Berlin. Let's take you back to Monday night. This Amazon, this Bionic Woman challenging Bret the Hitman Hart, and James E., she means business.
That's exactly right, and Bret Hart, no idea what to do. He couldn't hit a woman, but he didn't know how to handle this situation until security entered the ring.
Alex the Pug Porto making his way to the ring to take on Sal Sincere. But Mr. Cornette, I think that Bret Hart, at least in my opinion, is the most frustrated athlete in the WWF. There's no doubt that Bret Hart has obsessed about winning the WWF title. And it certainly seems to me that we're seeing a distinct change in the personality of the Hitman.
I don't have any empathy, sympathy, compassion, or anything else for Bret Hart. He's the Rodney Dangerfield of the WWF. He's getting no respect because now even the women think they can beat him up. But he's going to take all that aggravation out on one man at WrestleMania, and that's Stone Cold Steve Austin. And between Austin and Bret Hart, I don't see either one of them giving up, so we could be there all night.
That, of course, at WrestleMania 13 will be a submission match. The match can only be won by a submission maneuver. And indeed, Bret Hart or Stone Cold Steve Austin will have to give it up in that situation. Pinfalls do not count. No disqualifications count. No countouts. You must win the match by using a submission maneuver. And with that, you think about the sharpshooter as Porto goes up and over. Sal Sincere, both these young athletes making their first appearance in Germany. And a crossbody by Porto. And Alex Porto using some quickness here and an arm drag to take down Sincere.
And I'll tell you what, the crowd in Germany, they love a good collegiate-style wrestling background. They love a guy like Porto because they're really serious-minded wrestling fans over here in Europe. They want to see holds, takedowns, and counters. But I think that Sal Sincere is going to have to pull a few dirty tricks out of the bag, and I know he's capable.
You don't think these fans would like to see bald men posing?
I don't think these fans would like to see men with hair posing. I think they want to see action. They don't want to smell the steak. They want to taste it.
Porto up with a wrist lock on Sal Sincere. And certainly, you mentioned saw that woman a few moments ago, that bionic woman, the Amazonian lady. Why would she come all the way to Germany unless she and Helmsley had something going on? That's what I'm thinking. I don't have any proof. I'm just speculating. It's just a gut feeling or a hunch. But why would she come all the way to Germany, James E., if there wasn't something afloat with the Bionic Amazon and Helmsley?
Well, maybe we thought she was stalking the wrong person. We thought she was stalking Marlena. Maybe she's not. Oh, maybe she's stalking Helmsley, and she just doesn't want anybody else to get their hands on it.
Well, she ain't here looking for that Farfenugan or whatever the heck it is. And I'll tell you something else. The only common denominator about the... Well, look out! Here's a cover and a near fall. The only common denominator from the three times we've seen this woman is Helmsley. Every time we've seen her, Helmsley has been present.
I'll agree with you there, JR, but I think you're thinking a little bit too much about this woman because we're missing some great action here while you're thinking about your date tonight.
Good slam right there.
Did you get her phone number?
I don't need her. I'm a happily married man. My mama's watching. And right there's a good elbow by Sal Sincere. Both these are fine young athletes, and that won't get it done, I don't think. Rather lax, shall we say, in the cover.
Lackadaisical.
Another look at that elbow. Well placed right on the collarbone.
And then he didn't follow up on it. That's Sincere doing some more hot dogging that he's noted for, and sometimes it costs him.
Sal Sincere with that forearm. I don't know. I think he's in control, but I wouldn't want to bet a lot of money on this situation. As lax as Sincere seems to get, and that's the problem with some of these youngsters, is maintaining a high level of concentration.
Well, I know that later on in the program, we're going to take another look at that European Championship match between the British Bulldog and Owen Hart. And if anybody wants to learn anything about moves and counters, holds and counter holds in wrestling, then you got to watch that match. It's one of the finest that I've ever seen.
And another thing about that match, James T., neither one of those men are 40-year-old washed-up has-beens.
Oh, JR, your fangs are showing tonight. Wait a minute. So are Porto's.
Porto now. Oh, it's going to be reversed. The whip to the center of the ropes, and Sal Sincere with a sleeper on Porto, who turns into it and catches Sincere with a nice suplex.
Beautiful belly-to-back suplex, and Porto is going to have to rely on more maneuvers such as that. He's going to have to go to his strengths and stay away from Sincere's shortcuts in order to win this match.
Hey, folks, don't forget that this Monday night Raw is War, this Monday night live from Worcester, Massachusetts. And I wonder if your good friend, oh, good dropkick, Paul E. Danders, is going to show up and attack the King. There's a lateral press, and Porto can't find the three.
Let me tell you something. There'll be two things hit in a fight between Paul E. and Lawler. Lawler hit Paul E., and Paul E. hit the ground.
And, well, Sincere, well, it's that cradle. There's a counter, 1, 2.5. Nice amateur-based wrestling move by Alex the Pug Porto, the inside cradle. And, Sincerely, you're coming up.
Beautiful.
That should be it, and it is. Salvatore Sincere with his favorite maneuver, the Sincerely Yours. Very effective here on a game Alex Porto.
They were letting no grass grow. They were moving at 100 miles an hour, and Porto was the first one to make the mistake, and Sincere able to capitalize on it.
Well, I'm fond of you too, James C., but still to come tonight on Shotgun from Berlin, Germany. It's already been called the match of the year, the Bulldog and Owen for the very first European title.
And that's up next, but still to come, it's tag team action. Furnace and LaFon take on Bob Holly and Aldo Montoya. Jimmy?
The World Wrestling Federation is on tour and headed towards an arena near you. Tomorrow night, we make our way to the Springfield Civic Center. On Monday, March 10th, Raw is War in Worcester, Massachusetts. On Friday, March 14th, we take over the Louisville Gardens. 1 week from today, the 15th, we touch down in Landover's US Air Arena. 1 week from tomorrow, March 16th, we invade the Garden in New York City. Next Monday, March 17th, Raw is War in the On Center War Memorial in Syracuse. And 2 weeks from tomorrow, March 23rd, we're in Chicago for WrestleMania 13. There's only one World Wrestling Federation. Catch it live at an arena near you.
All right, New York City, here we go. Sunday night, March 16th, the return of the World Wrestling Federation live to the most famous arena in the world, Madison Square Garden. 20 WWF superstars in 8 killer matches. Your main event for the World Wrestling Federation title. Inside of a 15-foot-high steel cage, the brand-new champion Psycho Sid defends the title against the former 4-time WWF champion Bret the Hitman Hart, and Bret wants his title back in a bad way.
I might cry when I lose a title, but I won't quit. Psycho Sid, I want my title back.
And New York, who could blame Bret Hart for being mad, knowing he had Psycho Sid defeated till Stone Cold Steve Austin helped snatch the WWF title away from him? Will he recapture it Sunday night, March 16th, inside of a steel cage? You'll also see a revenge match. Savio Vega taking on Ahmed Johnson. The Undertaker against the man they call Vader in a casket match. An Intercontinental title match. A WWF Tag Team title match. Sunday, March 16th.
The co-owner of the Tag Team Championship. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, the partner, indeed the brother-in-law of the Hitman Bret Hart, as well as Owen Hart. Here comes the British Bulldog. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, from Berlin, Germany. We're not talking about team over 40. Now we're talking about two extraordinary World Wrestling Federation superstars in their prime. And I would suggest to you, you are going to see a wrestling match, the likes of which you have never seen before. Two individuals with great athleticism and a huge explosion. Only one of them can walk out of here from Berlin as the first European champion.
It's been over 20 years since the WWF introduced a new championship. And this was an eight-man tournament, single elimination. The Bulldog defeated Mankind and Vader to make it to the finals. But Owen Hart impressively defeated not only Flash Funk, but Bret the Hitman Hart in the semifinals to earn the right, the honor, to be the first European champion in the history of the WWF. And folks, you have the opportunity to see it right here tonight, and we're going to stay with it as long as it takes to get a winner in this one fall matchup.
Yes, indeed, a controversial matchup, I might add, with Owen Hart and the Hitman, nonetheless, in the record book of Ocho. Owen Hart victorious over Bret, the British Bulldog, against Owen Hart. Two co-holders of the Tag Team Championship. Both men will walk out of here the same, although one man will walk out of here with an additional championship belt around his waist. All right. You wonder whether or not we're going to see, as we suspect, an explosion here.
Don't say it, Mac, man. Don't start it again.
The animosity has been building between these two.
You know it's going to be a tremendous match, but you want to put some kind of family relations in it.
I think it's going to start out that way. I think it's going to start out almost on a scientific type basis. But then from there, as soon as Owen Hart, or for that matter, the British Bulldog, as soon as the cheating begins, I think that's when you're going to see the fireworks.
You know these are two great wrestlers like all the people in the World Wrestling Federation. We don't just drive up and down Interstate 75. We go all over the world just like these two guys to get a good match.
All right, Owen Hart now. Just like a plot of the baby boys with the British Bulldog. Bulldog. Ooh, very fancy maneuvers. Nice reversal there. Owen Hart now. How about that? Not to be outdone. And a reversal by Owen Hart. The Bulldog on his back. Nice takedown by Owen Hart. Bulldog turning into the wrist lock. Here we go. More fancy maneuvers now. And whoa, how about that?
Bulldog
brings the appreciation of this capacity crowd.
Bulldog certainly appreciates the fans here. It was in Wembley Stadium, 83,000, and saw the Bulldog beat Bret Hart. So the Bulldog's had a lot of success on this continent.
Oh, if I keep flipping, no. Bulldog kicks right out of that. You know, the thing about this is that each individual knows the other one's moves so well. Uh-oh, look at that. Owen Hart over the hip, nicely done. Nice takedown by Owen Hart, kick out by the British Bulldog. Right back up on his feet, nip up there. And again, both men displaying tremendous athleticism thus far, but you expect one of them to lose their temper at any moment.
There you go again.
And again, ladies and gentlemen, that's what it's all about. The European Championship.
And I was holding that belt when that picture's being made right now, and I'm telling you what, it weighed about 15 pounds, yep. Solid gold, and it would look real good on a honky-tonk man. Too bad they wouldn't let me enter this championship.
And right now,
power.
How about that? Yes, the power of the British Bulldog.
Bulldog's got a lot of it, more than Owen Hart. Owen Hart may be the quicker of the two, but in any event, there's no doubt the Bulldog is clearly the stronger of the two.
And again, I don't think we've ever had a match. How about that maneuver by Owen Hart? How about that? Over the hip, nicely done. Owen Hart now, off the ropes, and... Oh!
Powerbomb!
Wow! Again, each man, look out over the top to the outside! The British Bulldog! And Owen Hart down the outside! Another look here.
The attempted hurricanrana, and then it was a catapult right over the top rope. Once again, you see how strong the Bulldog really is, as the Bulldog is politely inviting his tag team partner back into the ring.
And his brother-in-law. And again, I don't think we've ever had a matchup in which the opponents truly understand the maneuvers of each other as well as these two do.
Well, you can't be tag team champions of the World Wrestling Federation unless you understand your partner. I know that. I've been in the ring, and I've had the opportunity to understand my partners completely, and I like to know everything they do at all hours.
Owen Hart now, reaching from behind. Let's see if he can escape. Up he goes. All the way over and out. How about that? Here we go. Roll up. 1, 2, and... Kick out by the British Bulldog. Right back up. Arm drag takedown.
Golok showing surprising quickness there with the arm drag takedown. And of course, no matter what happens in this matchup, it's certainly going to change the relationship in any event.
Yeah, I would think so.
To the tag team champions. How do you defend a tag title and keep that schedule going? Because the European Championship is going to be a very sought-after title, in my view.
No doubt about that, and that surely is going to create quite a bit, I would think, of jealousy between these two. If there isn't already. Owen Hart goes, no! Bulldog figured that one out. Owen Hart goes to the well. Once too often, stay with us for more action. We're back, ladies and gentlemen, from Berlin, Germany. Deutschland Halle, yes, for the first ever European Championship. The British Bulldog squaring off against his tag team partner, Owen Hart. Indeed, you are not watching the classic sports channel. No, you're watching the World Wrestling Federation, and you're watching two fine young athletes go at it here from Berlin, Germany, for the first ever European Championship as we take a look at this double feature.
Another great illustration of the power of the British Bulldog, and the Bulldog can outpower virtually anybody ever in the WWF.
Oh, wait a minute, one, two, and almost a count of three.
Nice crucifix there by the Bulldog.
And Bulldog now trying to set up Owen Hart. Yes, has him up. He'll let him think about it. Oh, no, he won't. He loses the balance. Owen Hart with a kick. No! And again, the Bulldog knowing full well the antics and the skills of Owen Hart. Likewise, Owen Hart knowing them about the Bulldog. Wait a minute. Here we go.
Owen Hart going for the enziguri, that head kick. And now this is a bow and arrow-like maneuver that takes a lot of power to pull off.
I don't know that the Bulldog can do that. A surfboard attempt here if he can get his brother-in-law Owen Hart up for a submission maneuver. And Owen Hart, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. The British Bulldog.
Pull back,
Owen.
Whoa,
how about this? How about that?
Catch your wave.
Come on. Owen Hart grabbing the official. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, next week, imagine this. Yes, live from Worcester, Massachusetts, you talk about Raw. Raw is war. Next week, and what a war it's likely to be, and teaming up The Undertaker and the World Wrestling Federation champion, Psycho Sid, teaming up next week on Raw, notwithstanding, of course, their championship matchup to come at WrestleMania.
And you got to wonder if Jerry Lawler may be in a little trouble next week if Paul Lee shows up with the rest of his buddies.
Oh!
Oh, hello!
What elevation! The Bulldog with a close. No! Oh, no!
Bulldog looked like he was on the Concorde there for a moment, sailing through the air at a high rate of speed.
And now Owen Hart celebrating a bit, much as we saw the British Bulldog a little bit earlier on. And oh, no, the Bulldog may have wrenched his knee.
Look, Owen's holding the ropes, asking him to come back in, the same as the Bulldog did.
And Owen Hart's talents are not exactly appreciated as much as the British Bulldog's talents are by this rather partisan crowd, I would suggest.
Absolutely.
Here in Berlin.
Bulldog, a native European.
And Owen Hart?
That surprised me.
Yeah.
That quite frankly surprised me, as you can hear the crowd surprised as well.
Well, it seems as though the World Wrestling Federation is full of surprises as of late. The British Bulldog against his tag team partner and brother-in-law, Owen Hart. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, Ken Shamrock is scheduled to join us from the Ultimate Fighting World. Scheduled to join us.
Oh, hello.
Next week as well, live when Raw is War from Worcester, Massachusetts.
Everybody wants to be part of the World Wrestling Federation. This is not the over 40 crowd, brother. I can tell you that.
No, not the senior tour. From the other side, and the British Bulldog. Nice leapfrog. Oh, no. Oh, no. Owen Hart just wrenched his knee. Owen Hart. Hey, no. Owen Hart now going to work in the British Bulldog. Here it comes. Here it comes.
A little subterfuge by Owen Hart. They call it playing possum down in Oklahoma. And Owen Hart just outsmarted his tag team partner.
Someone call it dirty tactics. And look at this. Sharpshooter coming out. Owen Hart. No. And a kick out by the British Bulldog.
Bulldog's got that strong lower body. He doesn't have any artificial hips, at least I don't believe.
And look at this. And again, here it comes. We've seen a lot of scientific wrestling, but now we're going to see something else, I think. Bulldog set up for the ride now. From the near side, over Owen Hart. Oh,
what a kick. Spinning heel kick by Owen Hart. Could be over. Owen is losing some valuable time. Should have made the cover right there.
I'm not so sure about that. I don't think Owen necessarily sensed his victory. And here we go, kicked in the midsection. Again, back to the double feature. Let's take another look.
I don't know. Looked pretty impressive to me. Got him right in the head.
That was devastating.
Tremendous kick.
I think Owen definitely made a mistake. Now we see the replay. double feature, and now Owen Hart trying to punish the back area of the British Bulldog.
Owen Hart now is singular in his purpose, trying to knot up that muscular lower back of the British Bulldog. You can get Charlie horses and spasms in your lower back, just like you can in your legs.
All right, Bulldog now to the buckle with authority. And Owen Hart really turning it on here against his brother-in-law and co-holder of the Tag Team Championship. But this doesn't have anything at all to do, this match, with the Tag Team Championship. No, it's the first new title in 20 years here in the World Wrestling Federation. And oh, Owen Hart now with a cover. He may be the new champion. And a kick out by the Bulldog. Owen Hart and the British Bulldog again. I don't believe we've ever had a match in which each opponent knows the moves of the other opponent as well as we have seen in this match.
This has been a tremendous matchup, which I knew it would be, although you're still trying to interject the family part of it. And I did understand that Stu Hart, he's had a brain seizure, something like what Elizabeth Taylor had this weekend. He don't know who to cheer for right now.
Not a very nice thing to say.
Tremendous crowd on hand here tonight in Berlin. The hospitality has been overwhelming. Indeed, the WWF truly worldwide. And wherever you are, we thank you for inviting us into your home as we're coming to you from Germany.
From the other side, the British Bulldog, ooh, takes a knee in the midsection. Owen Hart.
Looks like Owen's taking liberties with Davey Boy.
And that would be a mocking of Stu Hart, ladies and gentlemen, who is watching his son-in-law and his son compete, no doubt.
But I'm fans of both of these guys. I am. I really like both of them. I know them for a long, long time, and they're truly great competitors. And the only place to find competition like this is in the World Wrestling Federation.
And no doubt, ladies and gentlemen, both men have given it their all thus far. And we have seen, quite surprised, somewhat of a scientific matchup here.
Yeah, and sportsmanship has been the rule here thus far. But as the chips are thrown down here, and as this match winds down, you got to wonder if that will be the case. I don't think so.
From the other side now. Here we go. Cover and oh, that was so close. The Bulldog back up on his still another clothesline, and Owen Hart is really taking it to the British Bulldog. Follow up. Here we go with a cover. Is this enough? Not quite. Wow. What a matchup this is. Owen Hart against the British Bulldog, the kind of athleticism you only find in the World Wrestling Federation. We'll be back with more.
It's the biggest pay-per-view spectacular of the year.
WrestleMania.
The reigning champ is indeed the man. But can he fend off the phenom from the dark side? This angry hitman has a score to settle, but his target's a renowned stone-cold killer as well. Beware the dark alleys of Chicago when these warriors from the hood risk all in a cruel Chicago street fight.
WrestleMania!
There's only one WrestleMania, and it only happens once a year. Presented live March 23rd by PlayStation.
Two athletes, ladies and gentlemen. Again, exemplary of the athleticism you will see in the World Wrestling Federation.
Exemplary of the athleticism you'll see at WrestleMania 13. Just about 3 weeks away on pay-per-view. And folks, we all know that's the big dance. That's the big show everybody wants to be a part of. And it only happens once a year. Take it from Bo JR. Everybody wants to be a part of WrestleMania.
And I got news for all those Johnny come latelys. Don't even try to come there and get in. Don't even try to come. I want to be a point of the person that runs them off when they come to the door.
Now, wait a minute. Look at this. Now, the Bulldog set up. This could very well be the maneuver. It puts the Bulldog down. Owen Hart has been on a roll now for some time. Owen Hart sets up the British Bulldog. Here we go. From the top. Yes,
he counts
it. One, two, Bulldog. No, a kick.
What a counter.
Wow.
What a counter.
What a match this has been.
That was an amazing counter move.
And let's take another look at it, JR.
Certainly worth another look at the counter. The Bulldog holding onto the ropes, grabbing some leverage. That was a smart move by Davey Boy.
All right, off the ropes now. Underneath the roundhouse from the other side. Oh, what a clothesline.
Bulldog, he launched himself.
And another one. The Bulldog has turned the match around. Three clotheslines consecutively. And this capacity crowd very much in favor of the skills of the Bulldog. Up goes Owen Hart. Bulldog has turned this one around. A cover, a count. Boom. And Owen Hart escaping. What a matchup.
Can Owen Hart hang on here? If the Bulldog doesn't make a mistake, this one is
boom.
Sternum first. This one's almost over.
And here we go now. The powerhouse, the British Bulldog.
Hey.
I think he lost his balance.
Well, I'm not so sure he lost his balance, but he certainly gained even more of an advantage. Much like Owen Hart trying to put his feet on the ropes just a few moments ago.
Exactly. If you can get an advantage, you have to try to take it.
The British Bulldog, you know what, Art? They are tag team champions. They are partners. They are brother-in-laws. But tonight in Berlin, Germany, oh!
German suplex!
Got him!
No, he didn't.
Wow! Less than a half a count away from the German suplex, perfectly executed by Owen Hart. I don't care who wins this one, they're going to deserve that European championship. What a matchup this has been. The Bulldog and Owen Hart. Here we go, reversal. It's Owen Hart to the buffer. Now he puts on the brakes. Oh, this is it. Here we go. The power slam of the Bulldog can get... Oh, what a maneuver by Owen Hart and a new... No. Oh, wow. How close can it get?
Just tremendous.
There we go. Climb back. No. Rolling through and he... Oh, almost had him there. What a madness!
Oh, kick!
The Enziguri found it smart!
Cover
the Bulldog's down!
Go for the cover!
Shades of what happened to Shawn Michaels!
Go for the cover!
And Owen Hart now with the British Bulldog! He's gonna polish him up!
That'll do it, the sharpshooter.
Here we go! Owen Hart with the sharpshooter out in the middle of the ring! Applying on the British Bulldog!
What a matchup.
And I think Owen Hart thought that the British Bulldog had given up. Right now on his feet again, the Bulldog from the other side, Owen Hart, and oh, look at this, on his the British, here we go, pile drive, no, here we go,
power slam,
here we go, finally, yes,
he drilled him, it's over,
one, two,
kick out,
oh, I can't believe that, I can't believe it either, Owen Hart kicking out of that.
Bulldog wow. Can't believe it either. Nobody ever kicks out of that.
From behind.
On.
Here we go.
One, two.
Oh, he got him. No. One, two.
Sold in the tight.
He got him. He's finally over. Unbelievable. What a matchup. You're not going to find athleticism anywhere like this, except in a World Wrestling Federation. And give credit to both competitors.
What a match. What a tremendous match.
Ladies and gentlemen, to witness from Berlin, Germany, the first ever European Championship matchup. We'll go back and take a look at the replay of some of this action. And Owen Hart, take a look at it.
Well, Owen was going for the victory roll, but the Bulldog counters right here. There's no holding the tights. It was a legitimate pin. 1, 2, 3. The Bulldog earned the victory, but hats off also to the Slammy Award-winning Owen Hart.
And Owen Hart, I believe, look at the look of envy on his face. Jealous.
I wonder what Owen is really thinking. You got to wonder what Owen is really thinking right now. He may sucker punch the Bulldog at any moment.
There you guys go again. A handshake, you see? I told you. I knew it.
Don't turn your back. Don't turn your back, British Bulldog.
Keep an eye on Owen. Don't turn your back, Bulldog.
Bulldog. I don't know that I would turn my back, but nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, the World Wrestling Federation is definitely full of surprises. That much is for certain.
What a great moment for the British Bulldog becoming the first ever WWF European champion. And don't you go away. A lot more still to come tonight on Shotgun Saturday Night. Welcome back, folks, to Shotgun Saturday Night from beautiful Berlin, Germany. We'd like to take you back to last Monday on Raw. The Intercontinental Championship on the line. Rocky Maivia defending against a man they call Vader and James E. Vader was very impressive, especially in the early going.
Vader dominated almost the entire match because Rocky Maivia, rookie sensation though he may be, was unable to cope with the big man's size and power. But the guts of Rocky Maivia still held up, and he wouldn't quit until finally, at the closing moments of the match, with Vader in control, Mankind inexplicably interfered.
Well, I'll tell you, that gross miscommunication by Mankind, I think, cost Vader the Intercontinental title, and certainly it seems like
it would somewhat jeopardize the cohesiveness of the Vader-Mankind tag team.
Well, but at the same time, you know who Vader and Mankind are competing against at WrestleMania for the tag team title? The Bulldog and Owen Hart. And they've had their problems as well in recent weeks.
Well, Duck Furnace on your left, Philip LaFon on your right, certainly have not had any problems getting along and have been received so well here in Germany because, as James E. Cornette mentioned earlier, the fans here in Germany certainly appreciate pure athleticism and the great catch-as-catch-can style exhibited by the superstars of the World Wrestling Federation. And even though this team is new to the WWF, they've been regular tag team partners for about 7 years, competing primarily for the All-Asian organization, or All-Japan organization, in Tokyo.
And Furnace and LaFon have compiled a tremendous record there as well. And in this matchup with Holly and with Montoya, I think we're going to see a lot of scientific wrestling, a lot of catch-as-catch-can, a lot of good, solid action because of the styles of all four competitors.
Bob Holly and Aldo Montoya both are very talented and certainly would love the opportunity to be able to move up the ladder to main event status here in the WWF. And the way you do that is you impress people on television.
Whoa.
At least that's one way.
If Holly hadn't have ducked down just a little bit, his head would have been back in the 14th row by that Phil LaFon spinning back heel kick.
Bob Holly, a very accomplished race car driver, two sports star here in the WWF, and the native of Paris, France, Philip LaFon, tags in Doug Furnace, who grew up in Mickey Mantle's hometown of Commerce, Oklahoma.
But he played football and compiled a tremendous record at the University of Tennessee in Knoxville, where he was a hero as well as setting some, what, two dozen legitimate world strength records, JR.
Yeah, he's a powerhouse, no doubt about it. Bob Holly may find that out right here. Test his strength in this tag team matchup. And certainly Furnace and LaFon are gearing up for WrestleMania 13, just 2 weeks away on pay-per-view from the Rosemont Horizon. Look at the great athleticism of Furnace. High hip lock takeover and an arm drag. And Doug Furnace right into the arm bar on Bob Holly. It'll be a four-team elimination tag match at WrestleMania 13. Philip LaFon and Doug Furnace, along with the Godwins, along with the Headbangers and the New Blackjacks. Four teams in one match. It's a four-team elimination tag match at WrestleMania 13. And the winning team, oh, what a hip lock. The winning team will earn the right to meet the WWF Tag Champions at a later date. And, of course, the big question is, who will be the WWF Tag Champions after WrestleMania 13? Ladies and gentlemen, don't you go away. This tag team matchup will continue when we come back. Well, I'll tell you something, Raw is going to be war this Monday night. Psycho Sid and The Undertaker, who will meet at WrestleMania 13 for the WWF title, will be tag team partners this Monday night. And look out!
Whoa, wow.
And they will face, or at least they're scheduled to face, Vader and Mankind.
Wow!
That
what
is
a match!
Unbelievable matchup. You gotta wonder if Paulie Dangerously will show up with his ECW cohorts.
Brody, and, that's the word.
Confront Jerry the King Lawler. And Furnace with a dropkick right up in Bob Holly's face. There's a lot of press in a near fall.
Furnace gets more into that dropkick than anybody I've ever seen, and he just cuts a flip.
Oh,
and another
slam.
Flip. Holly cut that one.
And another near fall from the power slam. Bob Holly, to his credit, up very quickly. There's Holly now. One, two, three, no. Two and a half.
He couldn't get it done with the backslide, but Furnace has got to come out from under Holly, or he's going to lose this thing.
Front face lock. And a counter, inside cradle, Bob Holly has got another near fall.
Holly putting unbelievable pressure on Furnace, and Furnace has got to come out with something, and oh, he tried for the Hurricane Rana, and Holly dropped him right on his head. They're both down.
They block the counter into the power bomb by Bob Holly. Look at it right here. Good move by Bob Holly. Almost a seamless motion there by Holly, making the counter and then executing his own offensive maneuver. That's a nice piece of wrestling there.
I think Furnace and LaFon are surprised at the amount of competition that they're getting from Montoya and Holly, and Montoya comes off.
And Montoya caught. Ooh. Oh, and driven up, maybe inadvertently back into the corner. I think LaFon now is a legal man. There's a clothesline off the top. Furnace rolls over, holds the legs, but still cannot get three.
What's it going to take for one of these men to put the other way? Watch that cross body. He drug him all the way back across the ring and down.
And there's some teamwork right here. Bob Holly's in. Montoya with a pinning predicament. We've got an upset. No, we don't have an upset.
Furnace was holding LaFon up, and Holly drop-kicked Furnace out of the ring. LaFon went over backwards, and now once again, it's Montoya and LaFon, and there's that suplex, JR.
What a move right there. A devastating suplex. Well, both Raw is going to be more this Monday night. Sid and The Undertaker in a tag team battle. Plus, we'll hear from the Ultimate Fighter, Ken Shamrock. We'll see you Monday night.